Welcome to the second video about the discrete random variables. Last time, we generated a fair coin toss using R. Today, we will look at a general case of coin toss called Bernoulli random variable. In a fair coin toss, probability of getting heads is same as probability of getting tails, and it's equal to 0.5. In a general case, the probability of getting heads is equal to p, which is a number between 0 and 1. The probability of getting tails is equal to 1 minus p, which is often denoted as q. We call such a random variable x a Bernoulli random variable. A fair coin toss is therefore a special case of Bernoulli distribution with p equal to 0.5. How can we generate a Bernoulli random variable using R? Last time, we generated a fair coin toss by rounding a draw from uniform distribution. If the draw was bigger than 0.5, it was rounded up to 1. If it was smaller than 0.5, it was rounded down to 0. It turns out that we can do the same with any number p between 0 and 1. Let's choose p equal to 0.3. If we compare our draw from uniform distribution to number p, the result will be a Boolean variable, true or false, which assesses the truth of this statement. So this time, the number that we drew was smaller than p. Therefore, the result is true. If we draw a number which is bigger than p, then the result of this formula will be false. Note that true and false carry the same information as ones and zeros. In fact, if we treat those Boolean variables as integers in arithmetic operations, we will see that computer actually identifies true with 1 and false with 0. If I, for instance, add true to true, the result is 2, which means that true must be equal to 1. If I multiply false times 3, the result is 0, which means that false must also be equal to 0. So we can use true and false as ones. Therefore, we can use the same method as we did with fair coin toss to assess whether we get the right probability using our method. So let's choose a big number, n equal to 1 million, and let's generate 1 million of observations, and let's call it R, like result. So R is a vector with true or false. If we calculate the mean of R, it will treat true as 1 and false as 0. And will give us the percentage of times that we get 1. So in this case, we get exactly what we expected. The percentage of times when we draw 1 or true is 0.3, very close to our number p. We can do the same using a built-in function called rbinom. and it goes random binomial distribution. So it draws a number from a binomial distribution and it takes three arguments. First is the size of the sample, so in our case it's n. Second argument, how many times we toss coin in each draw, so in our case it's 1. And the third argument is the probability of getting 1 in each coin toss. So let's call this vector of results q. And let's apply the same test as we did to R. Here we also see that it generates with good probability zeros and ones. The binomial distribution that we use here is another generalization of the Bernoulli random variable. It allows us to have multiple coin toss in a single draw. Here we chose 1 to get a single coin toss in each draw. We will look at the binomial random variable in the next episode. I hope you enjoy that, and I'll see you soon.